not something that you have at night. No, my version of a dream is having a positive thought or a goal in your head and in your heart and doing whatever you can to achieve that. That's a dream in my book.
We used to walk to the bus stop every morning, and there was a woods, and behind the woods was a golf course, and one day he took a path through the woods and came out and saw what a golf course really looked like for the first time. I think he did get the bug, and it never left him.
First time I met Dennis was in Plainfield, New Jersey. We were playing in the New Jersey Open, and he must have been about 15, and he was out driving me about 20 or 30 yards, this little skinny kid. And I could see the talent. I mean, it's just very obvious.
He was a great high school player, great junior player. He went to North Texas State University and played there for them. And so he always wanted to play golf. His goal, obviously, was to get to the PGA Tour. And I could tell you this, is that I believe that Dennis Walters would have been the finest player ever to come out of the state of New Jersey.
It was a Sunday afternoon. We were out on the golf course, and he was coming out to meet us. Now, we were on a hole just ahead of him, and our four caddy, we just putted out. He's headed up the hill, and he came running back, and he said, "Ralph, come quick. Somebody flipped a golf cart." He said, "I think it's Dennis." So rushed up there, and I got there, and he's laying there having a hard time breathing. And I said, "How you doing, buddy?" And he said, "Ralph, it's serious. I can't move my legs." Bridget Shanley, she was the club champion, and she got a hold of a doctor. He had a pen or something. He said, "You feel this?" "Yeah, I feel that." "No, and that." "You feel this?" "No," and he couldn't feel about 4 inches below his belt buckle. He said he didn't feel it, you know. And he turned to me and he said, he said he's paraplegic.
All I remember is waiting in the waiting room when he was in surgery, and the doctor came out and said that he's never going to walk again. When the doctor said, "You're never going to play golf again," that made him angry. And he told the doctor, "Yes, I am."
You know, Gary Player called him on the phone. Arnold Palmer sent him a letter. Jack Nicklaus sent him a beautiful letter. President Ford sent him a letter. But the letter that got him the most was a letter that Ben Hogan sent him.
"Dear Denny, just recently I learned of your unfortunate accident, and with your permission, I would like to offer my thoughts and a word of encouragement. We know the human body is a great machine and can absorb many shocks. Even though it may seem slow, recovery is possible, provided one has faith, hope, will, and determination. From what I have heard about you, I am sure you possess these qualities. So please, keep battling, and you will soon overcome this bad interlude in your life. Sincerely, Ben."
Dennis was determined that he was going to hit golf balls again, and that's all he thought about. But now he had to figure out a way how to play. Obviously, his dad was extremely instrumental in helping him here. He figured out a way to put a bar stool on a golf cart, and he went out and he played golf.
After the accident, my dad retired from his job, and he basically devoted the rest of his life to Dennis.
His father was the one to get him going, get him up out of bed, get him to the golf course. He was a very inspirational person in Dennis's life, and he was a great motivator. He was unbelievable. You know, Tiger Woods had his father. Well, Dennis had Bucky, and it was very special to see.
"I'd like to introduce my other trusted assistant partner, my dad, Bucky Walters. Give him a big hand."
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Dennis Walters.
Okay, we're off to a good start.
Once the show got going, my dad traveled with him for the first 18 years that my brother did the show. It was just he and my dad.
"You can clap it, won't bother us."
He used to walk around with brochures, Dennis's brochures, in his back pocket. Everybody that he saw, if he was in the food store, he'd whip out a brochure and say, "This is my son.
Put it on a tee.
Excellent. Very nice.
I often sit in the gallery without him even knowing I'm there and watching him do his show, and you hear people, what they're saying. They say, isn't this amazing? Look at this guy.
Get out there.
I was paralyzed in 1985, and I was in college at the time, and I graduated and was out in the working world in 1987. And I saw people, a lot of my friends and my business associates playing golf, and I said, being a guy in a wheelchair, I said, that looks like a great sport for me. And I started trying to play golf. The guy I knew that sold wheelchairs said, I think you should go see this show. It's over at TPC Avenel.
T-T-A!
It'd been 4 seasons since I'd been trying to hit a golf ball, and I saw immediately the vision of how I was going to do this. And you just saw in an instant how Dennis had just blazed all the trails.
You watch kids, and it's hard to keep their attention, but you watch their faces during one of his clinics, and they're just glued to him. He just has that effect on people.
Now, a lot of people could have given up, but not Dennis. He goes along with a message. Don't give up because something happens to you. There's always light at the end of the tunnel. And I just love this guy so much.
Here's a man with a disability, and he decided that it wasn't going to keep him from playing golf. And he's shown people all over the world what a great person, what a great motivator he is for people. Dennis is an inspiration to anybody who sees him. You look at him and you say, wow.
The things that Dennis is doing are more important in your life than how many trophies are in your trophy case. And I think, bottom line, that should be one of our priorities, is how can we touch people in our everyday lives? That's what he does every day.
You probably don't meet a handful of people in your lifetime like this. I mean, he's just a shining light, you know. Proud to have him as a friend.
The fact that he has not succumb to an accident that could have probably just absolutely ruined his life. And I congratulate him, and I marvel at how well he does his work when I see him swing a golf club.
Somebody who's disabled and has overcome all these challenges to really participate in everyday life. And I think that is just a delight for me to see Dennis, and I'm thrilled for him.
The things that he's had to overcome in his life and the things that he's able to do now, he inspires so many people. It's been phenomenal to actually be a witness to it.
Desire, perseverance, courage, all these things sum up Dennis Walters. And taking those qualities that he had instilled in him by his father and his mom, and enhancing them and working hard and never giving up. To me, it's the greatest story in the history of golf.
They would just say that, you know, that he's their son and they're so proud of him and he's made such a success out of his life, and that even though his dreams weren't the dreams that they dreamed and he dreamed, you know, they were proud of him every day of his life. They had the best seats in the house. They're up there watching.
If you have a dream or you have a goal and for some reason it doesn't work out, never stop dreaming. Get a new dream. Get a new goal. No matter what happens, you have to hang in there.